Today we are going to discuss about mission vision, okay? Vision system for robots. So it is similar to our human eye. So it replaces human eye vision check. It is basically used for parts direction, okay? Parts direction and other inspection purposes. The robo equip camera, okay, camera to inspect the materials and other things. Okay. So it is nowadays machine vision plays a vital role in industrial automation applications. Okay, so today we see what are the components in the vision system. So the robo vision system, good. The vision system basically replaces human. So human sensor, you see, this is a human eye. The eye is a camera, so it has a sensor. The sensor senses and passes information to our that is called a grabber, okay, image grabber. So the image is the frame grabber is nothing but the screen, okay, screen like structure. It consists of various pixels. So the image is formed in the frame grabber, captured by the camera. Okay, the image captured by the camera is stored in the frame grabber. So like our human eye, that's why human vision system replaced by machine vision system. Let's see what are the important component in the machine vision system. Mainly measurement. So measurement, counting, so counting applications, then location, then decoding, okay, decoding. So these are all the four major parts of machine vision. Measurement through camera and other sensors. See how the machine vision arises initially. Actually, the machine vision is mainly used for complex operations and high speed inspections. So very fast, complex. Complex in the sense, suppose we have a PCB, so PCB tracing, okay, the track checking, the PCB line checking is very complex, okay. So electronic circuits, then high speed, it has to inspect with very high speed operation, then check for competence. Okay, completeness. So how to check for it, the process completely. Then shape inspection, shape. So how far it is, the shape is correct. Suppose if any damages are bent, suppose instead of circle, suppose the product is like this. So it will automatically reject from the conveyor. So may in the industry process, the vision system mainly implemented in the conveyor type of process. Okay. Next is pattern comparison. So you know that we have nowadays the product counting and the comparison normally done by OCR, object character recognition. Okay. So if you go to supermarket, in the supermarket. In the supermarket, we normally have the barcode, so the scanner, barcode scanner. So it will count by means of barcode or any other pattern. Then it measures, suppose say here how many objects are there, 8, 12. Actually, there are another object is also there that is not present. So total 9 items. Out of 9, only 8 is there. So one is missing. So this is an application of measurement. Then position, placing in the exact position and angular with the angular detection. So this angular detection. The object character recognition reading. Okay, this reading of IR code scanner. Okay, barcode scan. These are all comes under OCR. Then one dimensional, two dimensional reading, as well as this machine vision system also applicable for 3D vision. Nowadays 3D vision is more popular in industries. These are all important. You see, this is a typical component of a machine vision system employed in the industry. See here, this is a screen. This is a camera with the processor. So this may be PC or olden days it is CRT monitors. Nowadays these are all LCD along with the PC monitors. See, illumination, the main component of a robo machine vision consists of camera and lens for focusing. So camera and lens. Actually, there are in olden days, in most of the industry use very less resolution camera for industrial operation. So that camera called Vidicon tube cameras. After that, this is a very famous, you know that, CCD cameras. These are all MOSFET cameras, CCD, and the CAD cameras. So CCD means charge coupled devices with the MOSFET objects, okay? So this is illuminator, okay? So illumination by means of four techniques: front lighting, back lighting, structured lighting, okay? So there are different type of illumination. If you go to photo studios, they focus light to our face, so to get the clear object. So similarly, there are different type of illumination. Let's see one by one. Illumination by means of four types of illumination techniques for capturing the image. So this is a camera. This is a lens. So lens along with the camera and passes to image processing. This is the image processing stage. Image processing stage. So first stage is capturing through camera. Then it has to digitize, so convert into digital. Then it goes to image processing. So based on the pixels stored in the grabber, it is to be processed. So there are different stages of image processing, segmentation, region growing. So there are different techniques that you see one by one. So the object is moving. The object is here. So object is here. This is conveyor. So conveyor, this object is moving. So when the faulty object is comes here, this is the robo control system. Okay. So this will detect the faulty object. Then it by means of high blowing technique, this object is thrown away. Okay. So since it is not in the proper size or shape, so you see the other objects are in different shape. So this one is faulty one. So immediately through the robo hand or manipulator. So this is manipulator of robo. Okay, robo manipulator. So robo manipulated. So this finally it is yield for application through software. So this is our human vision system compared with the, this finally this is the digitized data. Like this is nothing but frame grabber. Finally it is stored in the frame grabber. So this is our lens, then camera. This is lens. This is lighting. Okay, lighting for illumination. Lens, camera. Then these are all the screens. So different stages of segmentation techniques. These are all the image processing techniques. There are various stages like segmentation, region growing, thresholding. So there are different stages. Let's see one by one. So first lighting with the image composition, image acquisition with the camera, image processing either two ways. One is internally in the camera, other one is externally in the PC. So we can extract the image using PC. So image future, this is a future extraction. So finally we can recognize the object through future extraction techniques. Future, so what are the future extraction? Say this is one object. Suppose this is a square object. Okay, so the square object is say it has 12 by 12 pixel. So 12 pixel horizontally, 12 rows and 12 columns. So 12 into 12, how much? So 144 pixels are there totally. So the total pixels, you assume the pixel, the image grabber, the pixel formed like this. So using the area, how much area means how many total pixels in the image. So image that is highlighted image, that is nothing but your future extraction. So future extraction consists of by measuring area, then diameter. So what is how much what is the diameter, then what is the even center of gravity. So center of gravity is also a future extraction measurement. So there are different techniques is that. Let's see one by one. So based on the future extraction, we can classify the type of object. So then classification, this classification involves in the application. Finally, it is yield to the machine control, robo machine control system. The implemented in the machine control system. Let's see, this is one small bakery where the faulty cookies. Okay, the cookies is let's see. You see in a bakery, the cookies are coming. Okay, so the cookies are coming from. Sorry. See here, this is a human being. So by means of human eye checking, so the faulty one is he removed the faulty cookie from the conveyor roller. So simple bakery. The bakery, he is seeing by seeing his eye, he is removing this bacon. Okay. So the faulty biscuits, say cookies or biscuits or any material. So he is standing there, he is removing the faulty items. So now we are going to equip one camera here in the top. Then one blowing system is here, we implemented. By seeing this camera and those camera captures the image of the cookies. If it is faulty, so simply blowing, say a robo blower, robo is equipped here. So robo manipulator. This is a robo manipulator along with a blower, pneumatic blower. You see what happens. So the human vision system, the eye vision system, is replaced by machine vision system. So this is a blower. So the moment the camera detects the faulty cookies, so immediately it blows. You see, it blows away from the conveyor. So only good cookies are falling in the filling in the case. Okay, this one typical example. Another one is, you see, this is another robo. Fast with the help of eye vision system, the robo employs for parts. Okay, parts replacement. You see, let's see. You see how fast, how accurately. You see the here top of one camera, here another one camera is here. You see right side, the right side. Here one camera. You see another CCTV camera here. So using these two camera, the robo manipulator does its job. So here you see sensing camera blinks. So this one camera, the another camera in the industrial environment. So this is the typical machine vision application in the industry. Similarly, see, with the help of cameras, how fastly the robo manipulators operates. Very fast in the conveyor. See, pick and place and palletizing. This also called palletizing robots. You see the machine camera blinking here. These cameras employ monitor the robo manipulator, and exactly you see this is a palletizer. See how fast it does the job. So without error, so accurate, the machine vision system for robo employs for very accurate and fast operation, very fast operations. Okay, so this is the overall machine vision block diagram. So this is the first. There are four stages in the machine vision system. Okay, the first stage is a function. See here, see, the first stage is sensing and digitizing data. So sensing and digitizing the image data. So first one is camera. So here in this stage, camera and lighting techniques. These lighting techniques are four types. That is illumination techniques, front lighting and back lighting. So what is front lighting and back lighting? Suppose object is here. Suppose light, say light. Light from here. So what happened? So this is the screen. So object, in front of the object, the light is applied. So the in front of the object means in the screen, the object color is black. So the image stored in the screen is black, whereas remaining places becomes white. So in terms of pixel means we normally convert the image into binary. Zero and ones. So if you consider black as one, then white as zero. Okay, or if you consider white as zero, sorry, black as zero, white as one. So in the frame image screen, it will store becomes ones and zeros. So that is signal conversion. Okay. So lighting, after lighting, camera captures the image, then that the camera image is serially sent to ADC. So what is ADC job? So ADC consists of sampler, quantizer and encoder. You see here, this is signal conversion stage. First stage, actually first stage is stage one is camera. Stage one is camera. That is called a image acquisition. So this stage is image acquisition. After image acquired, next stage is signal conversion. Okay, so signal conversion is nothing but converting the image analog into digital signal. So the ADC consists of three components: sampler, quantizer and encoder. Quantizer and encoder. So suppose the 8-bit ADC, I'll explain in next stage. First we see what are the stages. So after the converted image is stored in the frame grabber in the form of binary or gray level, gray or binary. Okay, binary means zeros and one. Gray levels means suppose the 8-bit ADC means there are 256 gray levels, right? Then lighting. So lighting here, structured lighting, front and the back lighting, structure lighting. Then beam splitters. Reflectors, actually it is wrong. Then specular illumination. Then some other types are there. So these are all comes in under sensing and digitizing the image data. Okay. The next stage. So this the image stored finally in the frame grabber. So next stage is the frame grabber. The stored pixel image is passed to computer for processing based on the algorithm. So computer processor is a storage. Is auxiliary storage for like a pen drive or some other removable storage, auxiliary or removable storage. In the image process and analysis stage, first stage is the data reduction. Then data reduction by means of two techniques, windowing and a digital conversion. Windowing and a digital conversion. Then segmentation, after data reduced to lower memory, that means what is the meaning for data reduction means, if suppose a VDCON tube consists of 128 pixels. So rows 128, columns 128. So suppose if 8-bit ADC means into how many levels? 256 levels. So 256 levels. So you just calculate the total total pixel memory, total memory stored in the computer. So 128 into 256. Okay, this is for 8-bit colored image. 8-bit colored image. The same thing can be reduced to black and white. Black and white means either 0 or 1. Okay, binary image. It reduced to binary. If it is reduced to binary, the value is 128 into 128 into 2. Only binary, two levels. So you see, if you multiply this 128, 128, 256, that will be large. It occupies more space. Whereas the binary image, when we reduced the color to binary, so colored image has more pixels. So we reduced to lower one. That is called data reduction. So the data reduction by means of two techniques. This is one digital conversion technique. This is digital conversion. Windowing means, I will explain with the windowing. Windowing means a particular part of the image is captured, used for analysis only, not from the whole picture, whole image. The particular part of the image is taken. That is called windowing. Okay, windowing. So then the segmentation. Segmentation has three techniques. Segmentation is nothing but detecting of image by means of digital technology. So thresholding, region growing, edge detection. These three are the segmentation techniques. Finally, future extraction. Future extraction by means of different parameters. The future extraction parameters are area, perimeter, diameter, compactness, and the center of gravity. So there are holes. Any hole in the image or not. So these are all the different future parameters we are going to employ to identify, to extract the object. Finally, object recognition. So in object recognition, see, object recognition, there are two techniques: template matching and comparison. Okay, so and nowadays there are latest algorithms come for the image processing techniques. Finally, these datas are used for applications, in the robo controllers. Controller, this is a robo control system. Okay, finally, robo control system. This is the manipulator. So task for the robo manipulator. So the main applications of the machine vision is inspection, identification, visual surveying, and navigation. Navigation by means of GPS. So vision, these are all important image acquisition. So image processing. So whether vision is two-dimensional or three-dimensional, the digital image is called a frame of vision data and is frequently captured by a hardware device called frame grabber, as I told you earlier. So frame grabber is capable of digitizing images, okay, at the rate of 30 FPS, okay, 30 FPS, simply called 30 FPS. The frame consists of matrix, row matrix and column matrix. It represents the frame grabber. The elements of the matrix are called pixels, okay, as I did to pixels. The Wiedekind tube, the pixels values are 128 into 128, then 256 into 256, okay, then 720, you know 720 HD, 720 into HD. So 720 HD means HD, HD vision. You know, nowadays 4K resolution to come for TVs, okay, smart TVs, 4K. So 720, you know, 1080 HD, HP. So these are all different high definition cameras and frame grabbers. So the number of pixels are determined by the sampling process performed by the images. So sampler plays a vital role for making the pixels. Each pixel intensity is converted into digital value, either 0 or 1. The camera technologies are olden days, as I told you, Wiedekind tube. Then solid state cameras by MOSFET technology, charge coupled devices, and charge injection devices. There are two types of cameras. We know only one type of camera, CCD cameras, right? So CCD means charge coupled devices. CID means charge injector devices. So the image frame will be having threshold. Threshold means we are classifying, grouping the image by means of binary value, okay, for various future measurements. To reduce the frame size, several hundred thousand bytes of raw image data, colored image data, into several hundred bytes. This stage is called data retention. The information gathered during the training consists of features such as area of the object, perimeter, length, major and minor diameter. So these are all feature extraction. These are all called feature extraction. Feature extraction parameter. So this is called illumination techniques used for lighting. So lighting consists of four type of, there are four type of illumination, four types. Okay. What are the four types? Diffuse lighting. So this technique is smooth, regular surface object. It is used where surface characteristics are important. So the diffusing surface here, the object behind. So we are lighting from the light source is here. The light source is passed to diffusing surface. From the diffusing surface, it falls on the object. Like if you would have seen this thing in the studios. So like an umbrella structure, like. In the studios, like an umbrella structure, so the light is passed through the umbrella structure. So it is coming back after heating it, coming back to object. So this type of so the object is now very clear because the diffuse is very smooth. This technique is smooth, so it falls on the object. Okay. So shadow is behind the object. So camera captured the object fully without any shadow. So backlighting is black and white image. It reduces only. So here object collimated source is applied here in this. So you see camera is another side. The light source is here, so object is here. So camera captures object as a dark, so black and white. You see here. So this is a spanner. The spanner is captured by the backlighting technique camera. So camera on the camera, see the holes through the holes, light passes. Light passes, whereas this area becomes dark. That is the backlighting technique. Okay, so this technique is suited for applications in which silhouette is of the object sufficient for recognition or other measurement. So this is the structured lighting. You see the object is here, camera is here, camera. Object. This is strips showing pixels. So that is part contour. So contouring like of structure. So the source, collimated source from here through creator. Okay, launch creators. So this consisting of projecting points, stripes, grids onto work surface. The lighting technique has two important advantage. One is a known light pattern on the workspace. Disturbances of this indicate the presence of an object, thus simplifying object detection problem. Okay. Then next is by analyzing the way which the light pattern distorted, it is possible to gain insight into three-dimensional characteristics. Then structure lighting with the back and front light sources. So this is a screen. This is a light source. Light play. This is plane. This is a light source. So either side of the light source, you see here, object is moving on the when it is moving on the conveyor. Camera placed here. So the camera captures image. So on both side, we pass light through light plane. so on either side. So this technique is suitable for moving objects. So the moving, when the object is moving on the conveyor, so this is maybe a conveyor. Okay. This is the directional lighting. So the light source is passed to the rough surface, the object with rough surface. This technique is applicable for object with rough surface. Okay, inspection of surface objects, object surface. It defects on the surface such as scratches can be detected by using high directed light beam of beam and measuring the amount of scatter. So how much scatter from the object. So this is illumination techniques, four types of illumination techniques. The robo vision application is categorized into sensing and digitizing and the image processing and analysis. In the sensing and digitizing data, first stage is analog to digital conversion, that is through sampler, sample and hold, and quantization and encoding. Then image device, then image storage. Then lighting technique. So this portion, there are two major sections. One is sensing and digitizing data. Another one is image processing, analysis and application. So in the image processing and analysis, image data reduction. This data reduction by means of two techniques. Data reduction by means of two techniques, windowing and image data reduction by means of windowing and digital conversion. So after that, image reduction, segmentation. So segmentation by means of three techniques, thresholding, region burrowing and edge detection. Then finally, feature extraction. After feature extraction has many parameters. So based on those parameters, we can extract the feature. Let's see some problems, some object, how to extract it. Then finally, object recognition. So this is by means of template matching and the backup storage data. So ADC, first stage is sampler, a sample and hold. What is a sampler? Sampler, sample and hold. Okay, then after sample and hold, it is passed to quantizer. So when we pass analog signal, say this is analog signal. So sampling means a train of pulses are passing through. So train of pulses. So here a train of pulses with the sampling time is passed through. Hello, could you hear me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So when analog signal is passed through a sampler, the sample and hold is nothing but simple understanding is, this is switching with the sample time, say 1 second or something. So this is a capacitor. So when we pass analog signal through this, so this switch opening and closing with 1 second, say I select 1 second time period. So what happened? So suppose the first sampling is zero. So the 0 volt is stored in the capacitor. Okay. So 0 volt is stored in the capacitor. So zero. Next, after 1 second, it takes this magnitude, this voltage. So this voltage is passed to the capacitor. Say that voltage is say 0.5 volt. So 0.5 volt. So the sample and hold. So at every sampling instant, the magnitude is stored in the capacitor. So the resulting output will be like this. Okay. So you will be getting data like this. So various magnitudes. So actually, this is called continuous time, continuous amplitude. So that is analog. Whereas after the sampler, we'll get a continuous amplitude and discrete time. So that's why called this a discrete signals. So from by sampling the analog signal, it becomes discrete, not digital. So after passing the discrete to quantizer, suppose 8-bit means say 3-bit. So what are the levels of quantization? 2 power n. So 2 power n is the quantization levels. So if you divide the V reference by 2 power n, it gives resolution. Okay, 2 power n. So 2 power n quantization levels. Suppose 8-bit, 3-bit ADC. So how many levels? 2 power 3. That is 8 quantization levels. So the quantizer generates serial of 8 datas. So 000, 001, 010, like that up to 111. Okay. So when we consider the after passing the 2 power n levels, we have to pass to a encoder. So what is the role of encoder? Encoder gives binary data, either 0 or 1, digital data. So after encoder only, you will get digital data. Clear? So this is say typical example for the machine, the image acquisition technique. So this is fun. This is the real image. This is fun. So this is the okay. So light is passed on the object. So the camera captures and sent to pixel sensor. So what is pixel sensor? This is a frame grabber. So where this is fun. So those places, those letters only highlighted, stored as a pixels in the image. So then we pass to the image processing analysis, we get the same parameters. This is fun. So this is recovered through camera. So stored through camera. This is a typical application. Please, all of you do this simple. A continuous video voltage signal is to be converted into discrete signal. Okay. So continuous video voltage signal is to be converted into a discrete signal. The range of the signal after amplification is 0 to 5 volt. The A2D converter has an 8-bit capacity. So ADC has 8-bit capacity. The analog voltage range is 0 to 5 volt. We have to determine the number of quantization levels, then quantization level spacing, the resolution, and the quantization. Please do it and tell me answer one by one. How many quantization levels? How many quantization levels? Please tell. Pune.
Sir.
Pune. Number of quantization levels, etna.
Four asin.
Super, super. எத்தனை பிட்டு ஏடிசி?
சார் எனக்கு நெட் கார்டு கட் ஆயிடுச்சு சார். என்ன க்வெஸ்சன் கேட்டீங்கன்னு எனக்கு புரியல சார்.
இப்பதான் சார் க்வெஸ்சன் தெரியலையா?
ஓகே சார்.
இதுல டிட்டர்மைன் தி நம்பர் ஆஃப் குவாண்டைசேஷன் லெவல். எத்தனை லெவல் இருக்கும்? குவாண்டைசேஷன் லெவல் 8 பிட் அந்த 2 பவர் 8. சோ 256 லெவல்ஸ். ஓகேவா? என்ன ரெசல்யூஷன்? லெவல் ஸ்பேசிங் எவ்வளவுமா? ஆகாஷ் இருக்கிறாரா? அருண் பிரகாஷ்
சார் ரெசல்யூஷன் 2 பவர் n-1 ஆ சார்?
2 பவர் n-1. குவாண்டைசேஷன் லெவல்ஸ்னா 2 பவர் 8. ஓகே. குவாண்டைசேஷன் லெவல் ஸ்பேஸ்னா ரெசல்யூஷன். ரெசல்யூஷன் எவ்வளவு? குவாண்டைசேஷன் லெவல் ஸ்பேசிங் ஈக்குவல் டு 5 / 2 பவர் 8. That is equal to எவ்வளவு? 0.0195 volt. Next quantization error. Resolution எவ்வளவுமா? The resolution. Okay. Resolution. Quantization level spacing na 1/2 power 8. So this is resolution. Resolution. ADC condensation level space. ADC condensation level space is 1/256. How much? 1/256 equal to 0.00039. This is condensation level spacing. This is resolution. Resolution always in terms of voltage. Error means in digital signal, error is always plus or minus of LSB. One LSB is nothing but one resolution. So plus or minus 0.0195. So plus or minus 0.0195 volt is the error. So this is the maximum possible error in digital instruments. See, 0 to 5 volt. How many quantization? See, this is binary number. This is grayscale. So 0 for black, 255. Last 255 is white. So the previous data is light gray. Similarly, 0 dark, sorry, black, next one level is dark gray, then little bit less darker than this gray. So similarly it goes to light gray. So this is the representation of our ADC ADC generation. This is binary number generated by the ADC. So you see one resolution, this is one LSB, one LSB. Okay, so 0.0195 volt. So every stage it is incremented, finally 5 volt. So this is categorized. So how many levels here? 256. 256 quantization levels. Next is sum. Consider a vision system using Vidicon tube. An analog video signal is generated for each line of the 512 lines comprising the faceplate. The sampling capability of the ADC is 100 nanoseconds. That is 100 × 10⁻⁹ seconds. This is the cycle time required to complete the ADC process for 1 pixel. Using American standard of 33.33 means 1/30 seconds to scan entire faceplate. So for each faceplate, it takes it scans 512 lines. The scanning rate is 33.33 milliseconds. So how many? There are 512 lines, 512 rows and 512 columns. Okay, so 512 columns. So totally 512. So what we have to do? Determine the sampling. Determine the sampling rate and the number of pixels that can be processed per line. So how to do it? Please do it. What is the cycle time per line? Cycle time per line. The cycle time per line equal to 33.33. That is cycle time is how much? 100 nanoseconds, right? 100 nanosecond is 0.1 × 10⁻⁶. Okay, 0.1 × 10⁻⁶ seconds. Okay, this is 0.1 × 10⁻⁶ per pixel. So this is for per pixel. What is the given American standard? 1/30. So the scanning rate. For 512 lines. So 512 lines it has to cover. So scanning rate for 512 lines equal to 1/30, that is equal to 33.33 × 10⁻³ seconds per pixel. Okay, So this is for one line. So for 512 lines, we have to divide this by 33 point. Okay. So scanning rate for each line. Scanning rate for each line equal to 33.33 into 10 power minus 3 divided by 512. Tell me. Sorry. 10 power minus 3 pair by 512 lines. 512 lines. So please tell me the answer for this. 33.33 into 10 power minus 3 divided by 12, 512.
Sir, 6.5 into 10 power minus 5, sir.
We should always consider either minus 6 or minus 9. That will be meaningful, right? Very good. Your answer is right. 65.1 into 10 power minus 6, right? Am I right or wrong? Seconds per line. Very good. Then what is the processing number of pixels? Number of pixels that can be processed per line. Sampling capability of the A to D converter is 0.1 into 10 power minus 6 seconds. Scanning rate for each line is 65.1 into 10 power minus 6. So what we have to get? The number of pixels. See here, in the first line, first this, seconds per pixel. Okay. Here, seconds per line. Now we have to compute number of pixels. Can you tell me, anyone, what we have to do to find the number of pixels? To find the number of pixels, per line, equal to what? Number of pixels per line divided by cycle time per line. Okay, 65.1 into 10 power minus 6 divided by 0.1 into 10 power minus 6 equal to how much? 651 pixels per line. This is the answer. Very important problem. 651 pixels. Pixels per line. See, already seen this image processing analysis. Four classification, four stages: image data reduction, segmentation, future extraction, object recognition. There are two techniques for object recognition: template matching, structural matching. So the segmentation, thresholding, region growing, and edge detection. Image data reduction, digital conversion, by converting the color code into lower grade, that is binary grade, that is called color coding. Then windowing is selecting the particular region. We will see. So this is a digital conversion technique. Digital conversion. You see, this is a high powered image. So they say this image is having 512 into 512 pixel. Image, then it is converted into gray level. Finally, this image is coming to, say, next is next image. This image is 128 pixel into 128. So this is still reduced.
Say 64
into 64 pixel grade. Whereas this is binary.
This image is binary.
So what we finally identified, there are two nose player, okay, cutting player. There are two nose player is there. So the two nose player is captured through the image. Captured through image. Finally, it is reduced to low. How do you call it? Low grade. That is binary. Either 0 or 1. So the memory size is still reduced. So this is called a digital conversion. See, let's see one simple problem for this. You see, for an image digitized at 128 points per line and 128 lines, there are 128 points or pixels. So points, nothing but pixels per line and 128 lines. Are there. That is 128 into 128. Okay.
128 into 128
image. So what we have to do, the total number of bits to represent the gray level values required if an 8-bit ADC is used to indicate various shades of gray. Okay, and the reduction in data volume if only black and white values are digitized. So the, if you reduce data volume to only black and white, what is the size of the image? So please do it. For A solution,
solution is for A, 128 into 128 pixel into 128 pixel, gray levels.
So gray levels means it has 8-bit. For 8-bit ADC, the gray levels are 256. So
256. So multiply 128 into 128 into 2^8.
Please tell me.
Please tell me.
So
141,94,304. 141,94,304. 96. 94,
sir.
128 into 128 into 256,
right? Yes, sir.
4196. Then?
94, sir. 4194,304.
4194304. Okay, good.
So this much memory, okay, pixel memory, right? Oops. Next category. When we convert this image into only black and white, so black and white means how many quantization levels?
So B, 128 into 128. Into
2 only.
Please tell the answer.
128 into 128 into 128. This is for 2-bit binary conversion.
So this is for
32.
Huh?
32768, sir.
128 into 128.
768.
இது மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணவா 128 into 128 into 2 ஆ
ஆமா சார்
இல்லையே தப்பா சொல்றீங்களா
இல்லையா இல்ல சார் 32768 தான் சார்
பரவா 128 into 128 into 2.
Very good. 3, 2, 7, 6, 8. 3 2 7 6 8 okay, so what is the reduction? No, 3 2 7 6 8, right, good. So what is the reduction in data? You subtract this from this. Subtract 32768 from 4194304. What is the reduction? Reduction in data volume. Subtract
means
4 1 6 4 1 6 1 5 3 6 4 1 5 no 1 6 1 5 3 6 1 4 1 6 1 5 sir 4 1 6 1 5 amma sir 1 5 apra 3 6 3 6 sir.
Much amount of data volume is reduced by converting the colored the gray level to black and white. This problem also important. The next technique is windowing. This is this also data reduction technique. See, windowing is the processing a portion of a stored image. Say this is a stored image. Okay, this is a stored image. You see, from the image I select only a particular region. So this like a window. So I process this portion alone, okay, in the faceplate, in the frame grabber. So this technique called windowing. So the portion of focus extracted for image processing to the image processing is the window. A rectangular window is selected as to highlight the component of interest on the screen. The pixel of the faceplate within the windows are processed and analyzed by the computer. Segmentation. So the segmentation is nothing but there are three types of segmentation. So actually the representation of different distinct part of the entire image data are grouped into one particular area. Similar characters is known called segmentation. Segment pichu pichu kondu varada segment. So the major segments of the image are regions and edge. Okay, so there are three type of segmentation: thresholding, region growing. Third one is edge detection. So what is threshold? So conversion of the image into binary technique. So it's a grouping of binary conversion technique in which each pixel is converted into either 0 or 1 binary value, either 0 or 1. That is as I already informed, either black or white. If you consider black as 0 or white as 1, okay, so this is accomplished by utilizing a frequency histogram in the image, establishing the intensity levels. So if we have various gray levels, then it depends on the ADC resolution, either 8 bit or 16 bit ADCs. So to be border between black and white, since it is necessary to differentiate between object and background. Say object and background means, suppose if front lighting means object will be bright, say object is, this is object. So if front light means object becomes bright, back light means object becomes dark. So suppose this is say these are all pixels, assume
These are all pixels.
So inside object. So what we have to do is in the object. This is object. So we have to put one. Say
wherever the edge is there, that pixel alone we have to mark it as one value one.
So whenever we put one, it represents the object in white color. So remaining these pixels are zeros. That means they are black.
They are black.
So we have to differentiate the image object and the surrounding background. So zero means background black. One means it represents the objects. Size and shape. Okay. Region growing. So region growing is a collection of segment techniques in which pixels are grouped in regions called grid elements. Grid elements. Representation zeros and ones for the object and background. So this is called region growing. This job is called region growing. You see here. This is an object, say it's like a key, say object. So the object is stored in the image. So this object is grouped in a region by representing the pixels. Actually, strictly speaking, this is a keyhole. So the hole should be here. We should not represent any one here. This is say zero because hole. So the key hole is represented here. So we have to group zeros and ones to the object image called region growing. After representing the region growing, we have to start from one end and we have to move for all the object, all the pixels. Moving up and down, yeah, by covering entire boundary borders, entire border of the entire border. So this technique is called edge detection. Also.